In this class, we are going to discuss about successive approximation type ADC. That means it's a analog to digital converter which converts a continuous type signal into a digital signal, that means into discrete form. So now here see the block diagram. So this is very similar to counter type, but we are having some disadvantages in counter type ADC. That is why its counter type ADC is taking 2 power n minus 1 time cycles, means after counting each voltage level, it's going to reset and it's going to count from initial itself. For example, if it's counted 5, if it want to count 6, then it's again starts from 1 2 3 4 5 6, like that. So to count n bits, so nearly it will takes 2 power n minus 1 cycles. That's why it's going to take much delay. So here now again that problem is going to reduce here. So we are considering that problem in counter type ADC, and we are going to reduce that number of cycles to count into some n clock cycles. Actually there we are using 2 power n minus 1 clock cycles, whereas here that number is reduced to n cycles. In n cycles we can convert our given analog input to digital output. So now why we are converting that 2 power n minus 1 cycles to n cycles, why we want to reduce, means just to fast up the conversion process. That's it. If number of cycles are decreased to convert, means obviously we are reducing the time taken for conversion. That means speed of operation. Just for speed of operation we designed this, to reduce or overcome the disadvantages in counter type. Now coming to this, we just replaced the n bit counter in counter type with a SAR, successive approximation register, so in which it's having an inbuilt algorithm. I will show you that algorithm, how it will generates that algorithm. And remaining circuit is as it is as counter type. That means whatever SAR value generated, that is converted into analog by using DAC. That analog is compared with our input voltage. Then if our input voltage is greater than DAC output, then this is equivalent to 1, then only this will work. Otherwise this is not going to work. Always for your op amp, your positive voltage must be high, then only your output of op amp is equivalent to 1 or high voltage. Otherwise your op amp voltage will be 0 whenever your positive voltage is less than your negative voltage, that means output of DAC. So this is the process. Now this is very important to know how this SAR, successive approximation resistor, will perform that algorithm. Means so whenever we are going to switch on the circuit, when we switch on the circuit, this SAR is going to put its MSB bit as 1. So it's going to place its MSB bit as 1, and then it's going to do the procedure. So see here, the two steps we need to understand here is, whenever on circuit on, then MSB of SAR is equivalent to 1. SAR output may be 3 bits or 2 bits or 5 bits or n bits. For example, if you are considering 3 bits, then these lines are only 3. That means only 3 bit data output you are going to get. So here, when Vin is greater than Vd, when Vin is greater than Vd, then what is going to do is, here you are going to set your next bit. Whenever your positive voltage is greater than your negative voltage, then you are going to set your next bit. Next bit means, so for example, A1, A2, A3 is there. This is MSB and this is LSB. I am talking about this. MSB after bit, I am considering like my next bit. And then next bit means like this, like this, like this. So from MSB to LSB, I am talking like this. So now here, if Vin is less than Vd, that means if Vd is greater than Vin, then your already set bit is going to reset. Already set bit is going to reset, and set bit is going to reset, and it will set next bit. Just keep in mind about these two points while making the algorithm. So just what we are doing is, when we switch on the circuit, your SAR is going to set your MSB as 1. If that is 3 bit, it's going to set your A1 as 1, remaining as 0. After taking that value into consideration, it's going to process like this. So for example, I'm considering my Vin is equivalent to 3. So I'm just considering my Vin is equivalent to 3. Then see here, so when Vin is equivalent to 3, so now, so I'm just comparing that side. So here my MSB bit, when I switch on the circuit, my MSB bit is going to set like 1. I'm just considering for 3-bit operation. I'm just considering 3-bit operation, 3-bit successive approximation type ADC I'm just considering here. So when we switch on the circuit, your MSB of this SAR algorithm is going to set like 1. I may have two cases. That cases may be either Vin is greater than Vd or Vin is less than Vd. When we set that value here, that value may be greater than our input voltage or less than our input voltage. We don't know. We are just setting that algorithm. That's it. So now, if Vin is greater than Vd, what we need to do, if Vin is greater than Vd, set your next bit. Already set this bit. You need to set your next bit means you need to consider like this. So for example, if Vin is less than Vd, if Vin is less than Vd, what you need to do, set bit is going to reset, already set bit is going to reset, and will set the next bit. And set the next bit means, so already set bit is going to reset, and set the next bit means like this we are doing. When Vin is greater than Vd, we are just setting the next bit. So when Vin is less than Vd, that means your positive voltage is less than your negative voltage of this comparator, then you are resetting your already set bit and you are going to set the next bit. Now this procedure is complete. Again, in this state you may have two options. So that means, so here for example 110 is there, so you will get another answer. For example, in this cycle, after completion of this cycle, if you got this 010, you may have two values. That means here also you may have two cases, that is Vin greater than Vd, Vin less than Vd. Here also you may have two cases. So and then Vin greater than Vd, Vin less than Vd. So I'm just considering these cases. So just consider like this. You can see here, for example, Vin is greater than Vd. What I told you, set your next bit. That means already two bits are set. So set your next bit means you are going to get 1111. And similar to that, so if Vn is less than Vd, what you need to do is, so already set bit is going to reset and you are setting the next bit. That means you are going to get 101. That means already set bit means here 1, that is going to reset and you are setting 1 here. And now here in this case, if Vin is greater than Vd, set the next bit. So 011, set the next bit. I am setting means making 1. Resetting means making 0. If Vin is less than Vd, set previous set bit, reset previous set bit and set next bit. So these are the two important points to get that algorithm. So 0, previous set bit is going to reset and you need to set your next bit. Now, so here also you are having possibilities, that is Vin greater than Vd, Vin less than Vd. So here also you are having two cases, here also you are having two cases, here also you are having two cases. So I am taking all that cases. So see that cases. So if Vin always top side I am taking greater than, downside I am taking less than condition. If Vin is greater than Vd, what we need to do? So we need to set the next bit, but there is no bit to set. So that's why we are taking as it is. If Vin is less than Vd, what we need to do? We need to reset the previous bit, previously set bit, and we need to activate the next bit. We need to reset the previous bit, previously set bit. In previous state, which bit is in set? So that you need to reset. And you need to set the next bit means there is no other bit to set. So you can stop the procedure. So for example, if you are moving with 4 bits, then you need to take 1 in that bit. So here, if Vin is greater than Vd, you need to set the next bit. So but there is no next bit here. So that's why you are taking 101. So now here you need to reset the previously set bit. And you need to activate the next bit. There is no next bit. So just you can do 100. You can reset your previously set bit. So now here, coming to here, you can see. So this is 011. So this is 011 means. So here if Vin is greater than Vd. If Vin is greater than Vd, you can set the bit. But there is no bit to set there. So that's why you are getting same thing. So if Vin is less than Vd, then you need to reset the previously set bit, that means 010, and you need to set the other bit, but there is no other bit. And last case you are having 001. If Vin is greater than Vd, so you need to set the next bit, but there is no next bit. So that's why, so 001 you will take as it is. If Vin is less than Vd, then in this case, previously set bit, in previous state, your set bit is this, that you need to reset and you need to set the next bit, but there is no next bit. So like this, you completed. You can see for a 3-bit data, you searched all 8 bits. That means 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. You can see the sequence. So you searched for all the possibilities of 3-bit data, that is from 0 to 7. In how many clock cycles you can see the number of clock cycles. From here to here, 1 clock cycle. From here to here, to move from this state to this state, another clock cycle. So to move from this state to this state, another clock cycle is required. In how many clock cycles we compared all the results and all the bits means in 3 clock cycles. So we compared with 3-bit data. That means, so for example, you are comparing just with Vin. So here, for example, Vin is equivalent to 3. Initially, you are having 4. Initially, your SAR is going to take 4. So, it's just taking that 4 is greater or lesser. So, that is greater. So, it will move in this direction. Your Vin is less than. So, again, next case, it will search like this. It will go like this or like this. Finally, it will select a value related to this voltage. So like this, your successive approximation resistor DAC, the ADC, that means analog to digital converter, is going to work. So generally, it will take 3 clocks for 3 bits, like that for n clocks. So it will take n clock pulses. So by observing this, we can say this is faster than counter type ADC. Because in counter type, every time counter is going to reset after every clock pulse, counter is going to reset after first clock pulse, counter is going to reset after getting two clock pulses, it's going to count again 1 and 2. For 3 clock pulses, again going to reset, and 1, 2, 3. So for every count, counter is going to reset in counter type. But here, as we are replacing that n bit counter with successive approximation register with this algorithm, it's going to search all the bits in n clock pulses. So it's, we can say this is faster than counter type ADC, whatever it may be. This is one of the best ADC, but here the complexity of circuit is high, because to build this algorithm and programming and all these will give you some complexity of the circuit, whereas in counter type that is easy to maintain and everything. So here complexity of circuit is high, but the operation is faster than counter type. So this is about successive approximation type analog to digital converter.